Hello and welcome to this video. In this short video, we will quickly review one of the most commonly asked dermatology topic, that is erythema multiforme. So let's begin. Erythema multiforme is a skin rash characterized by multiple, erythematous, annular, target-shaped bullseye rash, and the rash may blister. These occur on palms of the hand, on the arms, dorsum of the feet, and the knees. The disease is likely to have an immunological basis. What causes this condition? The condition is idiopathic in 50% of cases. Infection can also cause this rash. Viral infections that can cause this include herpes simplex, ORF, infectious mononucleosis, hepatitis B, and HIV. Bacterial infections include streptococcal throat infection and mycoplasma. Drugs implicated in causing this rash include penicillins, NSAIDs, sulfonamides, barbiturates, and carbamazepine. Connective tissue diseases, like SLE and sarcoidosis, and different malignancies may also cause erythema multiforme. Other causes include radiotherapy, pregnancy, and vaccinations. What are the complications? Stevens-Johnson syndrome is a severe form of erythema multiforme, with marked blistering, and two or more mucosal surfaces involvement, for example, mouth, eyes, and genitals. There is also systemic upset. So examine the mucous membranes for Stevens-Johnson syndrome in every patient with erythema multiforme. It is potentially a fatal condition. Eye involvement may cause corneal ulcers, conjunctivitis, uveitis. It may also cause toxic epidermolysis, necrolysis, or TEN. Coming on to the management. Erythema multiforme is usually a self-limiting condition, but get expert help in severe cases. Identify and remove or treat any trigger that you may find. For example, stop the offending drug and use antibiotic or antiviral if the etiology is infection. Use analgesia and topical glucocorticoids for symptomatic relief. In Stevens-Johnson syndrome, additional supportive care like oral toilet, rehydration, and analgesia is needed. And also seek ophthalmology input. Systemic steroids and immunosuppressive agents may be needed in some cases. Care shall be provided in burn units or ICU in severe cases, or in TEN. And that is it. Please like this video if you found it useful. Consider sharing with your colleagues, and subscribe our channel.